What is up, everybody? My name is Trevor Martin, and today I will be showing you exactly how I live in my 1993 Jeep Wrangler YJ. First of all, this whole back section is where pretty much all the magic happens. It's where I cook my food, where I sleep. Actually, pretty much the back section is the Jeep. There's really not much back here. So for the most part, I use this tailgate right here as a table for all my stuff. So like I said, most of my stuff is back here. So like I have, right here is where I keep my pans and my bowls, all that stuff. This is just a mesh bag I found, and I found out it's a lot easier to store stuff in. So I have this pot in here, as well as my utensils, different things. Like, I have this coffee maker and, you know, my plates, different things like that. Those all go inside of here, which just keeps it nice and tidy and prevents it from being able to just go everywhere, and also keeps Kai's hair out. Oh, in case you don't know, I also am living with a husky. So fur is inevitable. Right here in this ammo box, it's what I found is best to keep all my forks and spoons. So I keep all that in here. I also have a coffee grinder to make my coffee. I'm not the biggest fan of this setup. I've recently realized that having a good spork is way better than having forks and spoons and stuff. So this might be changing soon, but for the time being, I had to find a place for all my utensils. As far as water goes, I have this container right here. This is a lifesaver for me, and I use this as my main water source right now. So basically, if this container ever gets empty, I actually have two jerry cans on the side of my bumper. These guys right here. Water. And more water! That one's empty. This one's got water! Which I use to fill this thing up. So I will, if this ever drains out, I use those, and then once I get into town, I end up just filling up water there. So I actually carry about 15 gallons of water with me per trip, which is a pretty good setup. I also have this pot, which I just kind of toss around wherever because I haven't found a good place for it that won't stab it. So I usually just toss it pretty much wherever it'll fit, like right there or there. Now, since I have a dog with me, I have to carry dog food. He has an extra bag of food right here that I've been trying to use up, but for the most part, I usually leave his dog food right here inside of this bin. This prevents it from being sloshed around and stuff. It's worked good so far. It's a little bit better than having a bag, since bags can fall over easily and stuff if they're full. So I try to keep the majority of his dog food in this thing. And then if there's anything left over, such as right now, that works right there. This is my main pan right here. This is my dog fur. This is my cast iron frying pan right here, and I use this primarily for all my cooking. I love cast iron. A big misconception about cast iron is that stuff sticks in them. That's a lie. If your cast iron sticks, you're using it wrong. Inside of this Cabela's bag, the best bag you will ever have, these things are awesome. I put most of my propane in here for my stove. So I carry around a lot of propane. I found out the best way to do it is in this bag. I'm able to carry up to, like, I think 5 or 6 propane containers in there. I put them all in there, as well as some other things. I have supplies in here, like a sponge and soap and stuff. I leave that inside of this Cabela's bag. Keeps it all nice and organized. Now, as far as cooking goes, I actually use a Coleman propane 2-burner stove jigger, basically everybody knows it. I actually found another stove out in the middle of nowhere that somebody had forgotten about or left, I don't know which. I was using that for a while, but for my uses, I found out the 2-burner propane stove. It's simple, it's basic, it gets the job done. And so I went back to that, and it works great for me. It's a great little stove. All right, this right here is an Alpacool 50 liter fridge. You heard that, fridge. Set right now to 32 degrees, premium, nice and cold in there. Some of the coolest things about this cooler is that I can adjust it from my phone. And originally I was having a lot of problems with Kai stepping on the buttons. One time I got in the Jeep and found out he had turned it off, and another time he had set the temperature to like 50 degrees. So it got really warm in there, which is not good. But I found out I can actually lock the buttons from my phone, so if I bump into it or Kai bumps into it, it doesn't actually adjust. So right now it is locked onto 30 degrees, keeps it nice and cool in there. I like to have ice cold soda. Now this does make my milk a little bit slushy, but it's better to have everything a little cooler than a little too warm. So this cooler actually carries up to 50 liters worth of food. I have it a little unorganized at the moment, but I end up tossing a lot of stuff in there, and it's great to prevent food from spoiling. Definitely a huge upgrade from using a cooler. Now this runs for about $300. You can actually find this in the link in the description of my videos. This is a great upgrade opposed to using a cooler, and it's not that much more expensive. And at the end of the day, it saves you money on ice. I don't have to go into town to buy ice all the time, and I don't have to worry about food spoiling or breaking or... At some point this busted open and all I have left of the eggs is just a shelly mess. And as somebody who goes off-road with this thing all the time, I mean, it definitely keeps food together. I've never broken an egg in here. It is such a tight squeeze in here, and I'm trying to record everything I have. Now, that's where I keep all my cold food, but I also have some dry produce, which I have to find places for as well. That I have in a different place. And this was a new modification because I was keeping this in a different place, but I found it wasn't working great for me. So I actually keep all of my dry food in this Plano plastic bin that I actually have sitting on the fender well. The way to access that is a little bit more difficult, but I don't usually access this food. However, I have it here in case I never ever need to get to it. Follow up to this question is, what do I do with my dirty clothes? It is actually on top of this. I have a military surplus duffel bag that I use for all my dirty clothes, and when it's not very full, it actually works perfectly. Now, as far as seasonings go, I actually found this really cool hammock thing on Amazon. I saw this when I was doing a lot of research for how van lifers store stuff, and I haven't had the best luck with these. In fact, I might actually be getting rid of this. I feel like if I was living in a van, these would be fantastic, but I have a lot of stuff that I move around here in my Jeep, and I've actually gone through a couple of these now, and this one's falling apart as well. Now, this bag actually holds all of my seasonings as well as my spatulas and stuff. I think the biggest reason that it's falling apart is because it's just got way too much junk in it. So maybe I have to reorganize the stuff, but that's just part of it, you know, adapting to everything and learning what I use and what I don't use. Now, as far as sleeping goes, my dad actually built this wooden kind of cot platform for me to sleep on. It has been super comfortable. Originally, I wanted to specifically use a cot, and I actually found a way to fit a cot inside of the Jeep. I had a very similar setup that Jake had in his earlier videos. And for a while it was working great, but I noticed that the sag of the cot really was falling on stuff, and I ended up feeling anything that was underneath the cot that I was storing, I would lay on top of it and probably damage it, and it just wasn't working out for me. I think it really worked out great in the long run. It also allowed me to be able to fit things like the fridge inside of here, which I wouldn't have been able to do before with the cot. Now, as far as where I keep my clothes and everything, I actually do have a good place for my clothes. Originally they were actually sitting up there back where the dirty clothes are now, but I was having the problem with them always falling around, falling off, and it also made it really hard for me to access my food. So right down here I have this duffel bag of stuff. I keep all my clothes down here, all the clean stuff, and I use these organizing meshing bins. This really helps me keep my clothes tight in there and also not have to sort through it. So for example, this one has only t-shirts in it, and then, you know, I have like pants right there. Definitely helped with the organization. Huge lifesaver. My aunt was actually the one who mentioned these things to me. I didn't even know they existed. Definitely a good idea. Also down here is where I keep my DJI Mavic drone. I keep that down here, and I have a little bit of a power bank that's a little bit unorganized, but I'll show you that right here. Down here, I have a cool little charging station. These are all the drone batteries right here. And then back here is where I keep my 110 watt power inverter. Now that is how I charge all of my gear. That includes the fridge, my computer, anything else I charge back here. And I primarily use that as my main source. However, I would really like to get a solar setup in the future. It just hasn't been in the budget right now. But I actually have something special coming in the mail right now that should be a huge upgrade. It's supposed to arrive today. I'm gonna go pick that up today, and I think that'll help tremendously. I have this bag right here where I keep some of my stuff. I have this walkie-talkie strapped on here, as well as a tire gauge reader. I have some pliers attached here. I used to have some scissors in here, but I have no idea where on earth those went. Those disappeared. I have this military water can that I usually fill up, and I use it to give Kai water, keep his treats right here. Hand sanitizer has been a lifesaver. I use that anytime I can't, you know, wash my hands, but I still got something on them. Use the hand sanitizer. This is a recovery shovel. It's really good for a lot of things. Sean's taught me that it's good for playing with fire if you need to flip logs or anything like that. And then it's also just good if you really need to use the bathroom and you can't get to one. So far, I've only had to use it for that once, but it's still good to have it just in case. Now, under my seat is where I carry a couple other things. Dog treats. Gotta have those for Kai. This right here. Now, this is a personal jump starter. I have used this probably 10 times now. And this thing is incredible. It's like a little power bank that you have right there. It's just a battery. You plug it into your battery and you give yourself a jump start. Now, I was a little skeptical of these at first. I was like, there's no way something this small can jump start your vehicle. I've gotten at least 3 good jumps out of this without ever having to charge it. And I haven't even tried it a fourth time, but it could probably do that too. This thing right here. This is a brand of the one I use. I think I have this in the link to the description down below if you're curious. I think it was 75 bucks. Lifesaver right here. I've had to use this multiple times because I charge so much junk, and sometimes I wake up and my battery's just drained. And I gotta get back into town somehow, get back to society. This thing's great. Now I have a bag right here, this red bag on the front of my Jeep. Initially I bought that so I could use it as a med kit, but now I just kinda use it for a junk box. I put like flashlights in there, pocket knives. It's basically the junk drawer of my Jeep. It's just red box right here. Not a med kit. I wasn't able to fit the med kit in there, but it's still a really good bag. Now, I still do have a med kit in the Jeep. I have that packed right over here, and I use that from time to time. I put any like aspirin in there, bandages, and luckily I haven't had to use too many, but there has been a couple of times I had to pull a bandage or two out. I have this Trasharoo spare tire trash bag in the back. This is also super useful for recovery gear. I put Kai's leash right in here when he's not using it. I have my tow strap connected right there. I have a mallet here, a saw, some rope, and a funnel. It's really good to just put some of that stuff in there. It helps keep it out of the Jeep. It also helps prevent any smells from getting in the Jeep. I did find out though, it is really a pain in the butt to have to like clean out this Trasharoo by hand or disconnect it or anything. So a little modification I do myself. I just bought a bunch of black trash bags. And then I just put it in the Trasharoo. And that way, once the trash is full, I don't have to fish it all out. I just pull that bag out, toss the bag away, and we call it a day. Now, living in a Jeep Wrangler of all things, my Jeep gets a fair share of repairs, which means that I gotta carry around a lot of tools. I've been working on this thing ever since I got it, and I've had lots of problems with it ever since I started this road trip, just carrying around all the weight it has on the back of it. And it still needs more repairs for now. I actually wrecked it not that long ago, as well as some other instances that have happened. Lots of stuff break, and I have to carry around a lot of tools. I have a 108 quart container up here on my roof right there. One of those is completely full of tools. I use that. I can also do my own oil changes on the road. It's been super convenient. I have a 5-gallon fuel tank on top as well as my BMX bike, which I have not got a ride yet since it needs one more part before I'm able to actually use the brake. I have 2 more totes, one more that's on the rack, and I have another one on the tire carrier right here. And I use those from time to time, mostly for storage. I have a lot of stuff, honestly, that I need to get rid of. I could probably empty a whole quart of that. Initially, when I started this trip, I had 4 boxes on the top. But unfortunately, in the accident, one of the boxes broke, so I had to get rid of that. And I really just wanted to cut down on stuff in general. It's always adapting, like I said, and I will probably have to do another video like this in the future when I reorganize. But for now, this is how I've been living in my Jeep recently.